يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون. إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم. إن الذين ينادونك من وراء الحجرات أكثرهم لا
And from his narration on the authority of Ibn Abbas that he said regarding the interpretation of Allah's saying, O ye who believe! Be not forward in the presence of Allah, O ye who believe! Be not forward in the presence of Allah, do not start with any word or action until the Messenger of Allah, Bu, commands or prohibits you first. It is also said that this means, do not start immolating your sacrifices on the day of immolation, and his Messenger. Until you receive Allah's command and the command of His Messenger. It is also said that this means, do not oppose the Messenger, and it is said this means, do not contravene the Book of Allah or the practice of His Messenger, and keep your duty to Allah, fear Allah in relation to saying or doing anything without the command of Allah or of His Messenger, and do not oppose the Book of Allah or the practice of His Messenger. Lo! Allah is hearer, of what you say, knower, of your works. This was revealed about three prophetic companions who killed two men from Banu Salim when the Muslims had a peace treaty with them, without being commanded to do so by Allah or by His Messenger. Allah, glorified and exalted is He, forbade them from engaging in any matter without a command from Allah or His Messenger.
هم صبروا حتى تخرج إليهم لكان خيرا لهم والله غفور رحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا أن تصيبوا قوما بجهالة فتصبحوا على ما فعلتم نادمين. واعلموا أن فيكم رسول الله لو يطيعكم في كثير من الأمر لعنتم ولكن الله حبب إليكم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبكم وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان أولئك هم الراشدون. فضلا من الله ونعمة والله عليم حكيم.
O ye who believe! This was revealed about Thabit ibn Qays ibn Shamas, who raised his voice in the presence of the Messenger of Allah, Bu, upon the visit of the delegation of Banu Tamim. And so Allah forbade him from doing so. Allah said, O you who believe in Muhammad, Bu, and the Quran, in reference to Thabit, lift not up your voices above the voice of the Prophet, Allah bless him and give him peace, nor insist in talking when the Prophet, Bu, is talking, nor shout when speaking to him, nor call him by his first name, as ye shout one to another, as you would do with one another. Rather you should reverence and honor him and address him by, O Prophet of Allah, or O Messenger of Allah, or O Abu al-Qasim. Lest your works be rendered vain while ye perceive not, lest your good works be nullified for failing to observe propriety and reverence towards the Prophet, Bu, while not knowing that your works are nullified.
طائفتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا فأصلحوا بينهما فإن بغت إحداهما على الأخرى فقاتلوا التي تبغي حتى تفيء إلى أمر الله فإن فاءت فأصلحوا بينهما بالعدل وأقسطوا إن الله يحب المقسطين إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهم ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون.
Lo, they who subdue their voices. This also was revealed about Thabit ibn Qais ibn Shamas after he was prohibited from raising his voice, in the presence of the Messenger of Allah, Allah bless him and give him peace, praising him for lowering his voice in the presence of the Prophet, saying, They who subdue their voice in the presence of the Messenger of Allah, those are they whose hearts Allah hath proven. Those are they whose hearts Allah has cleansed and purified, unto righteousness, from sin. It is also said that this means, Those are they whose hearts Allah has made sincere to the profession of Allah's divine oneness. Theirs will be forgiveness of their sins in the life of the world, an immense reward, an abundant reward in the garden.